Might be 8 years away, but the Brisbane 2032 Olympics and Paralympics are already being labelled a joke after the Premier pulled the purse strings shut on a new stadium. And the move is putting Queensland in the record books for all the wrong reasons.
Hell hath no fury like a Queenslander scorned.
It's an absolute schmozzle.
We've wasted now 3 years.
This is a case of politics getting in the way of progress.
The backlash against Queensland's Olympic preps ramping up today as it was revealed Brizzy's athletics venue will be the smallest in 100 years. Branded an embarrassment compared to the Paris Stade de France and LA's Los Angeles Coliseum.
It does seem a bit crappy that, you know, we don't have a new stadium.
Brisbane will just be an embarrassment.
I don't think the Suncorp's up to the standard for the Olympics.
Stephen Miles opting to upgrade the current Queensland Sport and Athletic Centre and hold the opening and closing ceremonies at Suncorp Stadium to save on costs, rejecting a review which instead recommended building a brand new $3.4 billion stadium. It was a podium-worthy backflip from the Premier.
I know that I said I'd do what the Quirk review recommended, but I cannot support the option that they have landed on.
Athletes quick to point out the flaws in the government's no-frills approach.
This review cost $450,000, and I know that the state premier is talking about cost of living and not wanting to spend things, but you've just spent $450,000 on a review when you had a perfectly good action plan.
The stadium saga comes after the premier was forced to deny the state was looking to dump the games altogether.
It's reassuring for the athletes that the games are going ahead, but I think that we are really squandering an incredible opportunity by all this bickering.
New South Wales offering to take the baton and run with it if Queensland doesn't deliver.
We ran the world's best Olympics. Our record is unmatched and we've set a very high standard for Queensland to reach, and if they can't do it, they should give me a call.
So are the games doomed 8 years before the Olympic flames even been lit, or can Queensland pull off a Bradbury and bring it home strong?
Congratulations to Sarah on her photoshopping that story. Three-time Olympian Lisa Curry is not only a Queenslander, she knows her way around an Olympic stadium. Lisa, the Premier says that Queensland just can't afford a new stadium. What do you think of that?
Well, Waleed, maybe they should have thought about that when they put their hand up. And in fact, my feel is that Anastasia probably resigned because she knew what was coming. But every country that puts their hand up for an Olympic Games, they know how much it's going to cost. They know if they have the infrastructure or not. And I'm disappointed that now they're doing a bit of a backflip and saying, you know, it's too expensive. It's just not good enough.
So, yeah, maybe they shouldn't have put a bid in, but they have and they've got it and now they have to figure out what to do with it. Is it a fair enough call to say we're going to use current facilities?
Well, I think they have to. There's no other way but to use the current facilities that we have. And, you know, we've used the Gold Coast pool for major competitions. There's no problems about that. But as far as the opening and closing ceremony, the locations that they're looking at now, where the funding was going to be, what do they want, $3.8 billion to redo it? I don't think so. And I think with careful camera work and lighting and a few flags up here and there, you can make anything look great on TV.
Yeah, we know that well.
We've just got to zhuzh up the place.
We'll get our director over there.
That's right. Let's just zhuzh up. We just need to zhuzh up Brisbane a little bit.
Pimp my Olympic stadium. Lisa Curry, icon. I want to talk banana bender to banana bender here. Do Queenslanders, do they really want the Olympics to happen in 2032?
Well, OK, let's put it this way. My first major competition was in Brisbane at the Commonwealth Games, and it was incredible. The people, being in a hometown crowd, had an absolute ball. I was in Sydney when Cathy Freeman won the 400. Mind you, I wasn't in the stadium. I was outside in a pub with everyone else. And it's electrifying to see the best athletes in the whole world converge. It is worth it. It is amazing. There are people who will watch those Olympics and go on to be Olympians in the future.
First the Commonwealth Games, now this. How does Australia look on an international stage?
Oh, look, cancelling the Commonwealth Games is an absolute embarrassment, I think, from the rest of the world. And these are competitions that athletes train for their whole lives. And I know it doesn't mean that much to the normal person on the street, but when you're an athlete, it does mean a lot. It is your whole life. If, you know what, I can't even imagine cancelling the Brisbane Olympics. That is just not an option to me. We would be the last laughing stock of the world and we would never get the Olympics ever again. I'm disappointed that we've got to this point. So, you know, the AOC should have been on board. They know how much an Olympic costs to run. Sydney knows how much it costs to run, but I don't want it to go to Sydney. It's our turn. So I think, you know, zhuzh up QE2, zhuzh up Lang Park and let's get it done.
Well, yes, Sydney has thrown its hat in the ring. They want to take over from Queensland. Do you think they should? Would that send a message to Queenslanders? They would kind of fight for it a bit more?
No, we are not going to give it back to Sydney. They've had their chance. Melbourne's had their chance. And I think Brisbane wants to have their chance as well. I'm happy to have the archery out here. You know, there's plenty of things we could aim at. I've got a few spare beds. Perfect. We can put people up.
Hey, at least
we will make it work.
Is it true that the Matilda, you know, the winking Matilda kangaroo, at a servo in Gympie somewhere?
I have to drive past it to come here.
Oh wow. That can be part of the zhuzh up.
Yeah, the zhuzh up.
Well, we've got a little trailer. Maybe we can put Matilda on the trailer. We'll take her down the Bruce Highway, put her back in Lang Park or QE2. And see if that wink works again. But, yeah, no, she's only 8 minutes away from here. I drive past her all the time when I come here.
Oh, there you go. Give her a wink.
We've already saved millions.
Yeah.
We're on the way.
You've also got the Stefan Sky Needle still there.
Oh, Stefan.
I don't charge much to bunk in at my place either if some of the athletes want to stay at my place.
That looks like a pretty comfy shed behind you there, Lisa, I have to say. Thank you very much for your time.
Giddy up.